Hey, hi all. Today, let us see how to activate the material ledger in S/4HANA system. Yeah. So while you are doing FIMM integration, without activating a material ledger, user cannot be able to post the goods receipt entry through the MIGO transaction. What is exactly material ledger? Material ledger is used to value the material price in a different plans with different pricing, like the local currency or a document currency. Company code currency, what all currencies they do a reporting. In earlier ECC system, we normally don't do a revaluation or the pricing for these materials, okay? But in S/4HANA, we have this capability to do the valuation of a material, yeah? Here we call it as a term, valuation area, most of the time. Valuation area is nothing but it's your plan. How many plans you have in your organization for each and every a valuation area or a plant, you need to activate the material ledger. Let us see how to activate the material ledger. What is the path to use? Yeah, let me go to the next slide. Here, you have a there are three steps mainly you do here. One is a material ledger type. Yeah, the second one is assign currencies, material ledger types to the valuation area. Yeah, finally, activate the valuation area for a material ledger. Okay, here I'll just go back. If you want to see the path, you just read it from here. Yeah, let me go to the SAP system and show you. What if I don't activate the material ledger for a valuation area or a plant? Let me post a goods receipt. Yeah, I'll give my purchase order. Yeah, this is my plant, nothing but a valuation area. Let me just press enter. Everything it got ticked. Let me see my storage location. Yeah, let me check this. Yeah, it was locked by some other screen. The other screen that is also mine. Let me come back. Yeah, let me do the check now. You see, everything looks okay. Document is okay in a down. Yeah, let me try to post the goods receipt. You see, the material ledger is not activated for the valuation area. P2DA. What is P2DA? P2DA is nothing but it is my plan, okay, where I have created a purchase order and I am trying to post a goods receipt. Yeah, system is telling, hey, you have not activated the material ledger for this plant yet. Please go ahead and activate it. Let us see how to activate it. Yeah, as usual, I will go to the SPRO. Yeah, the financial accounting. It's SAP S/4HANA on-premises 1909 version we are using currently on the screen. Financial accounting ledger. Yeah. Then you go to the parallel valuation approaches. Yeah. Multiple approaches you go. Basic settings you go. Yeah. Then check material ledger settings. You go to the check material ledgers. And you see here, the first one is assign currency types and define material ledger types. Let us go. Yeah, let us go. And I've defined the type 9000. If you see here, if you select and define the valuation characteristics, I currently defined only 10. 10, most of you know, it's a company code currency. Okay, I'm just evaluating my materials in a valuation area level with the currency type 10. Yeah. This is being done. Next, let me go to the other step. Assign material type, assign material ledger types to the valuation area. Let me just click this. Yeah. So let me just position and see what is my valuation area. I'm getting error. P2DA is my plant. Yeah. You see, it is not here. What we have to do, we just have to create it. Before this, if you want to see, let me go back to the third step again. I have not yet configured the second step. I'm going to the third step. Activate a valuation areas for a material ledger. Let me see what it will do if I go here directly. What is my valuation area plant? P2DA. Yeah. If I give here, see, it is not activated and there is no material ledger type. I cannot activate it. It is grayed out. So I cannot do anything. That is the reason in order to activate this phase, you first have to complete the second step, which is assign material ledger type to the valuation area. Okay, just go to the new entries. What is the valuation area? It is nothing but my plant. what is my plan? P2DA is my plan. Yeah. And what is the material ledger type I was talking? I had created 9000 with the document currency. Sorry, not the document currency, which is a 10 company code currency. Yeah, this is green status. You just save it. Done. It will be a transporter. It will save. Yeah, the changes are saved. Yeah, you see the data was saved. Let us go to the third step. Yeah, which is activate valuation area for material ledger. Let us go inside. Click on activate material ledger. If you see here now, you will see the difference. P2DA is my valuation area. You see, it has filled with the 9000, which is a material ledger type, and this is a material ledger activation button. We just need to select this. Now it is enabled. I have selected, and price determiner, I need to select it too. Yeah, you just select and save it. Okay, yes, you just click, and again it will save in your transport. Yes, data is saved. Yeah, after completing this, let us go back and check material ledger settings also. Yeah, and you just give your valuation area, which is P2DA in this. You just execute it. Yeah, it has run. You just go back. It has run. So after doing that, there is one important step that normally forgot, and still we see the material ledger is not activated. If you see here, let me go to the Migo again. So after doing this, let me see. Yeah, let me try to check. Everything looks okay. I've not plugged any items since I forgot this. Let me do this, check again. Yeah. This is processing already. Yeah. Okay. Let me just check here only. Let me try to post it. See, the valuation area P2DA not yet productive with the material ledger. However, we activated, it is not productive yet. How to do that productive? We need to use one transaction. Yeah. You might forget. Just a note down. That is a transaction code CKM. Okay, start. You just click enter. Select your plan. Okay, P2DA, which is a valuation area also. You just click in a test mode first. Yeah, immediate. Okay, just check it. Okay, elbow CL. Let's see. Yeah, let us see P2DA I've selected. Let us see the post test run. I just executed it. Yeah, if see everything looks okay, you just go back. Okay, you just go back. Remove the test run. Run it in a background. Okay, just execute it. Immediately you run. Okay. This is a test system. LP01. As the device, yeah, it is processed. Yeah, this is the way you have to activate your material ledger in S/4HANA system. Thank you. Let us see finally. The before job was scheduled, I just released the job also in SM37. I just posted the goods receipt also. Yeah, this is the document which is generated. Okay, let us go to the purchase order and let us verify finally. And yeah, so yeah, I'm in my purchase order. If you see the purchase order history tab got generated and goods receipt got posted successfully. Yeah, let us see the document also. Yeah, the material ledger also posted. You see the raw material got debited as per the goods receipt, and the GRIR clearing got credited. This is the integration with it, the NAP5MM integration. So the inventory got fixed in BSX and the GRIR with the WRX. This is a different topic. Yeah. Thanks for watching. Bye.